For the EMG, EMG stands for electromyograph. Electromyograph is an electrodiagnostic medical technique for evaluating and recording the electrical activity produced by the skeletal muscles. So the most common electrodes used for surface EMG recording and nerve conduction studies are circular discs about 1 centimeter in diameter that are made of silver or platinum. For now, for non-invasive recordings, such as this one, proper skin preparation is required, which normally involves cleansing the skin with alcohol or application of a small amount of electrolyte paste. Helps to minimize the impedance of the skin electrode interface and improve the quality of the recorded signal considerably. And for direct recording of electrical signals from nerves and muscle fibers, a variety of percutaneous needle electrodes are available as illustrated here. So here is a percutaneous needle electrodes. So when we say percutaneous procedure, it is a medical procedure or method where access to inner organs or other tissue is done via needle puncture such as this one. So rather than using an open approach, no? So the most common type of needle electrode is concentric bipolar electrode. As shown in this one, it's composed of a lead, insulated hub, hypodermic needle, and here is a bipolar electrodes. So this electrode is made from thin metallic wires encased inside a larger cannula or hypodermic needle, such as this one. So the two wires here serve as a recording and reference electrodes. And another type of EMG electrode is a unipolar electrode, which is composed of a lead, insulated hub, and a sharp needle. So, this electrode is actually made up of a thin wire that is mostly insulated by thin layer of Teflon, about 300 mm near the distal tip. So here is the actual procedure being done. Using an invasive EMG electrode in comparison with a non-invasive electrode, skin contact only, and with this one, contact with the muscle. For our next topic is all about EEG electrodes. EEG stands for electroencephalograph. It's a test used to evaluate electrical activity in the brain. So the most commonly used electrodes for recording signals from the brain are cup electrodes, such as this one, and subdermal needle electrodes. Cup electrodes are made of platinum or tin, approximately 5 to 10 mm in diameter. These cup electrodes are filled with conducting electrolyte gel and can be attached to the scalp with an adhesive tape. So actually, brain cells communicate with each other through electrical impulses. So an EEG can be used to help detect potential problems associated with this activity. Now, recording an electrical potential from the scalp is actually difficult. So because hair and oily skin impede good electrical contact. So sometimes, clinicians prefer to use subdermal EEG electrodes instead of metal surface electrodes for EEG recording. So these are basically fine platinum or stainless steel needle, approximately about 10 mm long and 0.5 mm wide, which are inserted, no, under the skin to provide a better electrical contact. So billions of nerves in your body, in your brain, produces very small electrical signals from patterns called brain waves. So during an EEG, small electrodes and wires are attached to your head. The electrodes detect your brain waves, and the EEG machine amplifies a signal and records them in a wave pattern on a graph paper or a computer paper or a computer screen, such as this one. Now, for the microelectrodes, a microelectrode is an electrode used in electrophysiology, either for recording neural signals or for electrical stimulation of nervous tissue. So, these are biopotential electrodes with an ultra-fine, such as this in the figure, tapered tip, that can be inserted into individual biological cells. So the tip of these electrodes must be small with respect to the dimensions of the biological cell to avoid cell damage and at the same time sufficiently strong to penetrate the cell wall. So here is the biopotential microelectrodes. The first one is a capillary glass microelectrode, which is composed of potassium chloride electrode, silver or silver chloride wire, glass capillary, and lead. And for the insulated metal microelectrode, it's composed of a tip, shank, metal, insulation, and a stem. And for a solid-state multi-site recording microelectrode, it is composed of four exposed recording electrodes, insulated lead, support structure, bonding pads, and lens. So in this one, for the capillary glass microelectrode, it has a hollow glass capillary tube, typically 1 mm in diameter, which is heated and softened in the middle inside of a small furnace and then quickly pulled apart from both ends. So the larger end of the glass, is then filled with potassium chloride electrolyte solution. A short piece of silver and silver chloride wire is inserted through the stem to provide electrical contact with the electrolyte solution. So when the tip of the microelectrode is actually inserted into the electrolyte solution, ionic current can flow through the fluid junction at the tip of the microelectrodes. So this establishes close electrical circuit between the silver and silver chloride wire inside the microelectrode and the biological cell. So for the insulated metal electrode, it is a different kind of microelectrode made from small diameter strong metal wire such as tungsten and stainless steel, which is illustrated here. So the tip of the microelectrode is usually sharpened down to a diameter of a few microns by an electrochemical etching process. So the wire is then insulated up to this tip. Now, so for the solid state multi-site recording microelectrode, so its probe consists of precisely a micro-machined silicon substrate with four exposed recording sites. One of the major advantages of this fabrication technique is the ability to mass produce very small and highly sophisticated microsensors with highly reproducible electrical and physical properties. So here is an example of microelectrodes inserted in a brain. So it is an invasive electrode, inserted in a brain inside the brain or brain or spinal cord actually, So solid state microfabrication techniques commonly used in production of integrated circuits can be used to produce microbes for multi-channel recording and biopotentials or for electrical stimulation of neurons in the brain or spinal cords. So that ends our presentation for today. Our next topic will be physical measurements. And as a review for our discussions, so we have discussed the concept of electrolyte and the metal electrode interface, in which we say that electrodes convert ionic signals from the body into electrical signals in wires. And electrolyte and metal electrode interface is actually developed when a metal is immersed in an electrolyte, then a potential or charge distribution is set up across the two phases. And we have discussed also about ECG electrodes. We have said that ECG electrodes are typically wet sensors requiring the use of conductive gel to increase conductivity between skin and electrodes. We have also discussed about EMG electrodes. We have said that the bioelectrical activity inside the muscle of a human body is detected with the help of an EMG electrode. So actually, there are two main types of EMG electrodes: the surface or the skin electrodes, and the inserted electrodes. And also, we have discussed about EEG electrodes. And we have said that during an EEG, small electrodes and wires are attached to your head. The electrodes detect your brain waves And the EEG machine amplifies the signals and records them in a wave pattern on a graph or a computer system. And we have also discussed about microelectrodes, in which we have said that a microelectrode is a biopotential electrodes with an ultrafine tapered tip that can be inserted into individual biological cells. And we have evaluated problem pertaining biopotential measurements, specifically regarding electrolyte or metal electrode interface. We have solved the produced current with regards to the electrodes involved in it. So for your problem set, you will be asked to calculate also the current that will flow to the electrodes, given the following resistance of 14 kilo ohms, given the electrodes of cadmium and zinc, which is placed on an electrolyte solution. And also explain what will happen when the silver or silver chloride gel of an ECG electrode used to monitor a patient in the ICU dries out over time. So that formally ends my presentation for today. Thank you and have a good day.